Back to JSG Woodworking. I know it's been a little bit since I've put out a video. Apologize for that. But today I wanted to do an update on my Wen Lathe. So I've had this Wen Lathe for just over a year. It's the Wen 8x12 mini lathe. It's been my only lathe. It's been pretty good. It's really good for pens and that type of small stuff. But because it is only a third horsepower, it does get bogged down quite a bit. Let me switch you around and I will show you what it looks like now. You'll have to kind of excuse the mess. Trying to rearrange a few things here. I just got a new addition to the shop, which I'm going to do a shop tour after this and talk about it. So yeah, this is my Wen. So it does pretty good. It really does. It's nice. It's got a slow start. It's held up pretty well. For all the abuse and the lack of care I give this thing, I will admit, as you can see, I have not cared for this thing nearly as well as I should have. There's CA, I'm getting a little rust buildup. There's acrylic everywhere still from the last pen I tried to turn. Here's what's left of it. Unfortunately, it was one of my first attempts at label casting, and yeah, as you can see, it turned out oh so well. I did turn this beast. So I don't know what type of wood it is. I found it in a dumpster at a building site right next to my house when they were building that house there. And so I did get this turned, but it was very rough on the lathe. I don't know how well you can see this, but if I put this on there flat, it is cockeyed. So it does not sit on here flat anymore. I have bent it. Yeah, you can kind of see the bend right there. So this larger tool rest is basically toast. So now I'm stuck with this little 4-inch one. This mallet took me quite a while to do. I was constantly stalling out the motor. And that kind of stuff. Let me get you switched back around here. Okay. Sorry, you'll have to deal with some glare off my bald head. So yeah, the mallet turned out really nice. I mean, I really like it. It feels good. I have just a little tear out, but I think for my very first mallet, I think I did pretty good. I mean, it's not great. If a highly experienced wood turner said that they turned this, I probably would laugh at them. But overall, I don't think it's bad for my first mallet. I didn't record it. I kind of wish I did so you could have seen my struggles. But it's all good. So, sorry about the hand. Joys of cell phone camera. But yeah, I mean, overall, it's a good lathe. It's a good beginner lathe. Would I buy it again? Honestly, for the money I paid for, or my dad paid for this, since it was a birthday present to me, I should have gone with the Harbor Freight and dealt with the bands and manually changing the speeds. The only advantage this thing has to the Harbor Freight is the variable speed. I think the Harbor Freight is a half horse. And so I think it just overall, I think that would probably be a better lathe for a beginner or somebody who's just turning pens or bottle stoppers. So yeah, I mean it works, but it's not great. So yeah, that's kind of my 1 year update. It works well. Would I buy it again? Probably not. Would I recommend it to anybody else? Yes and no. If variable speed is something that's very important to you, and you don't have, you know, the $500 for a Jet or a Nova, it's worth it. Would I take the Harbor Freight over this now? Yes, and I should have. My dad was willing to purchase that one for me or this one. I went with this one because it was a little bit cheaper and I like the variable speed. I wish I would have gone with the Harbor Freight. But so yeah, that's it. It's a good lathe for a beginner to learn on. Since it's not very strong, it stalls out a lot. So if you're worried about catches and that type of stuff, it's not bad. It's not like these, you know, 2 or 3 horsepower, big, huge Lagunas that you see a lot of people turning on. And so instead of catching and just blowing your piece up, it just kind of stalls out. Can you turn very big pieces? No. With the mallet, I actually had to take the banjo. Sorry, let me get you switched back around again here. When I was making this, I had to take the banjo because the piece I had was like 7.5 inches. I had this angled off like this, which I know you're not supposed to do, and then had this turned. So there was really nothing underneath this supporting it like there should be. And that, I think, probably contributed to the bending of that tool rest, because all the support was out over here. But that was the only way. I mean, you can see this gap here. I mean, it's okay, so it's probably not even 8 inches between the tool rest banjo here and the center. I mean, you're looking at maybe 3 inches. And yeah, so I mean, this was basically the setup of it. You know, granted, it was longer than what's here now, but to do anything on it, I had to angle it out like that. So anything large, it just can't handle it. The banjo is too long or too thick. I mean, two of my fingers wide. And I'm not a little guy. You know, I'm 6'1". So, I mean, I've got substantial hands. Yeah. Would I recommend it? Really not. Unless all you're planning on doing is pens and that type of stuff. It's a good pen lathe, but that's about it. You get this faceplate, but you can't turn anything nearly as big as this faceplate is, because, I mean, you're dealing... You can't get the banjo underneath it. So if you've got anything, because you can kind of see where the square was, you know, on this, because this was the last thing I turned on here. So, I mean, you can kind of see where the square was. So, I mean, it was as wide as this is down here. So, I mean, it's what? I just happen to have a measure. So, yeah, it was 4 inches. 4 inches square, and yeah, it just, you can fit, you know, 3 inches there at the most, 3 inches wide, not even 3 inches, 2 3/4, you know, is all you can get there. So I mean, this is 1.5 inches tall, so you know, out of their 8 inches, you've got 3. I mean, here you go from that, and yeah, it's 4.5 inches up to the center line, or close to the center line, so you can get something total 8 inches, but in all reality, you're looking at, you know, 5 at the most, or not even, yeah, so 2.5 wide, so yeah, about 5 inches roughly, somewhere right around there in all reality. It's a good lathe, but it's not great. You know, it does the job, barely, but it does the job. So yeah, that's my 1 year re-review of the Wen Mini Lathe. Go buy Harbor Freight. Bye.